Oral melanoma is a rare and aggressive type of cancer, originating from the pigment-producing cells called melanocytes. It accounts for 1-2% of all oral malignancies. It generally shows up as a dark brown discoloration. It can also be black, blue, or purple, and sometimes it appears as areas of depigmentation on the mucosal surfaces of the mouth. These surfaces include the gingiva, palate, tongue, cheek, or lips. The most commonly affected sites are the maxillary gingiva and the palate. The exact cause of oral melanoma is not well understood. However, it is believed to arise from the malignant transformation of melanocytes. These are the cells that are responsible for producing melanin, which is the pigment that gives the color of the skin, hair, and eyes. In the oral cavity, melanocytes are found in the basal cell of the oral mucosa. Both the oral and skin melanomas originate from melanocytes. However, oral melanomas are more rare than the cutaneous counterparts. They also tend to be more aggressive and have a poor prognosis. The risk factors for oral melanoma are also not well defined. Unlike skin melanomas, it is not related to sun exposure. Some studies suggest a potential association with tobacco use and chronic denture irritation. Generally, oral melanomas are seen between the ages of 40 and 70. It is also more common in the Japanese, African, and South Asian populations. Diagnosis of oral melanoma is primarily based on clinical examination and biopsy of the suspicious lesion. Their silent clinical nature can result in them being easily mistaken for harmless pigmented lesions that show no symptoms. The sooner they are diagnosed, the better, as their prognosis is often poor and have only a 10 to 25% survival rate at the end of 5 years. Histopathological examination of the biopsy sample is essential to confirm the diagnosis. Incisional biopsy is indicated for larger lesions, in which a part of the lesion, usually from the thickest region, is removed. Excisional biopsy is indicated for smaller lesions, in which the entire lesion is excised or removed for assessment. Advanced imaging techniques, like a CT scan of the head and neck, may be used to determine the extent of the disease and if it has spread to other parts of the body. Common differential diagnoses include amalgam tattoo, melanocytoma, oral melanotic macule, and blue nevi. Management of oral melanoma involves a multidisciplinary approach. Surgical excision is the primary treatment for the malignant melanoma, aiming for the disease-free margins. Depending on the stage and extent, additional treatments like radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and immunotherapy may be recommended. Regular follow-up is crucial to monitor recurrence rates and to manage any complications. To summarize, oral melanoma is a rare and aggressive mouth cancer with a poor prognosis originating from the melanocytes. It presents as colored spots or depigmented areas in the mouth, more commonly in the maxillary palate and gingiva. The potential risk factors include tobacco use and chronic irritation from dentures, though the exact cause is unknown. It is more prevalent in Japanese, African, and South Asian individuals, typically occurring between the ages of 40 and 70. Diagnosis involves clinical examination, biopsy, and sometimes advanced imaging like CT scans. Conditions like amalgam tattoo, melanocytoma, oral melanotic macule, and blue nevi are usually considered as differential diagnoses. Management primarily entails surgical excision, with additional treatments such as radiation therapy, chemotherapy, or immunotherapy where needed.